Learning the ins and outs of OBS Studio can be nice, but sometimes you just want to jump ahead to the best possible settings. This is the video for that. I'm going to skip over creating scenes and sources and all that and get right into tackling the bit rates and what the different settings are for a high quality live stream or video recording. Let's jump in right after this.
You may proceed.
I am Epos Fox, and this is the video where we will cover bit rates, resolutions, frame rates, and so on. If you need to know how to set up OBS Studio in the first place or aren't understanding some of the lingo, consider checking out some of the rest of my OBS tutorial course in the video playlist in the description below for more information. When adjusting your OBS settings for streaming and recording, there are three main numbery things that you need to worry about, so it's important that you really understand what they are and which ones you need. Those numbers are resolution, frame rate, and bit rate. Real quick, for those that don't know what the numbers mean, let's summarize. Resolution refers to the dimensions in pixels of your video feed. This is usually 1920 by 1080 or 1280 by 720, but if you have monitors of different aspect ratios or sizes, your resolution could be different. On newer Windows versions, you can right-click your desktop and choose Display Settings or Screen Resolution to find your monitor's resolution. Alternatively, you can create a display capture scene in OBS, and when you choose the monitor, it will tell you the resolution across all your screens on any operating system. When setting your base resolution in the Video Settings tab, this should be either your computer monitor resolution or an input resolution of an external capture card, if you are recording from a console or external video device. Change the scaled resolution setting to be the same as your base resolution, as we will scale for streaming in the output settings later. Choosing frame rate is fairly straightforward, either 30 FPS or 60 FPS. You can choose 25 FPS instead of 30 for better performance if your computer is struggling to stream, but for a recording, this would not look very good. 30 FPS is easier to stream and record and will look much better for lower bit rates while streaming. 60 FPS looks a lot smoother for most games and is often preferred by viewers, but it takes a more powerful PC to stream. Next, go over to the Output Settings tab. Here, we will adjust your bit rates for streaming and recording and tweak a couple of advanced settings. At the top of this window, click the drop-down where it says Output Mode and change it from Simple to Advanced. Simple mode may look easier to manage, but those settings don't always work the best and I just simply never mess with it anymore. Advanced mode makes sure you can set everything perfectly. Ready to follow along? If you set your base resolution to 1080p, you want to check rescale output for streaming settings and choose 1280 by 720 or 854 by 480. The lower resolution you choose, the better your video can look for lower bit rates. Think of quality like filling a bowl with water. The width of your bowl is your resolution. The height of the water is your image quality per your bit rate. The smaller a bowl you put your water into, the higher the water and the image quality is. However, if you play games with a lot of text, you may want to focus on 1280 by 720 or 1920 by 1080 if you can push higher bit rates, as that will make the text sharper. I stream at 1280 by 720. For rate control, choose CBR. This is a requirement for Twitch. YouTube Gaming and other services don't require CBR, but it is still easier to stream overall. CBR means that no matter how much action is happening on screen, OBS is pushing the same bit rate. The other option, VBR, stands for variable bit rate. This means that if your stream moves to a still image or less action scene, it will lower the bitrate to match. This might seem like a good idea, but on Twitch it can cause issues for some viewers to keep having to reload the stream. Make sure keyframe interval is set to 2 seconds. This is a requirement of both Twitch and YouTube and most platforms. I recommend setting the CPU usage preset to faster. This setting can affect your image quality. The higher you set this, the less CPU usage will be required for the streaming process, but the worse your image quality will get. Lowering this setting will improve image quality, but put a lot more strain on your computer. Profile should be set to main, and tune should be set to none. Leave VFR unchecked, and leave X264 options empty. Let's go back up to your bitrate. Twitch has recently updated their broadcast requirements to allow streamers to stream up to a full 6 megabits per second. However, not all viewers can view such a high bitrate. There's a lot of controversy about claims that not everyone can watch high bitrate streams, but I personally have had plenty of people complain about stream buffering for higher bitrates. If you are not a Twitch partner or do not regularly get transcoding enabled on your streams, I recommend setting the bitrate to around 2000 or 2500. This is generally viewable by everyone. If you have transcoding for your stream, the option to change from source quality to high, medium, low, and so on, then you can stream the full 6000 bitrate and viewers can select a lower quality to match their internet speeds. Not all streamers get transcoding. Transcoding is guaranteed for partners, but only allocated to non-partner streamers based on the availability of Twitch servers, with a priority placed on affiliates. It's also worth noting that not all viewers know about the quality selection menu, and thus even a high bitrate stream with transcoding may inadvertently turn some viewers away. I stream at a bitrate of 5750, as I regularly have transcoding enabled on my stream. Keep in mind, your internet connection plays a role here. I've covered the bitrate and bitrate testing and stuff in a previous video. Your internet can only upload so much. If you're streaming to YouTube, you can push virtually as high of a bitrate as your connection will allow. Obviously, you need to keep your internet upload speed in mind. Go to openspeedtest.com or speedtest.net and run a speed test to find out your connection's upload speeds. Keep in mind that this is the available upload speed for your entire home, so you cannot push the full upload speed of a connection for a stream. Generally, you want your stream bitrate to be less than 70% or 75% of your total upload speed. You will also want to make sure that your streaming rig is on a wired Ethernet connection to your router, and that nothing else on your network is doing any serious downloading or uploading while you stream. Click the Audio tab. Twitch supports a max audio bitrate of 160. Set your streaming audio track, typically track 1 and assigned in the streaming tab, to 160. If you're streaming to other platforms and can support higher bitrates, change this to whatever you like. I have my main mix track for streaming set to 160 and the other tracks for recording set to the full 320. If you also want to record while you stream or are just recording in the first place, click the Recording tab. Select your recording destination, preferably a secondary hard drive or SSD inside your computer, though the normal C drive is okay. For recording format, choose MKV. This will work the same as MP4 recording, but prevent the file from getting corrupted if something goes wrong during the stream. You can convert it to MP4 with OBS later by going to File and Remux Recordings. This also keeps multiple audio tracks intact for editing. If you just want to record the exact copy of things that you've live streamed, for encoder, choose the Use Stream Encoder option, and this will allow you to record an exact copy. If you want to record a higher quality copy, however, proceed with the video. Most people will want to leave the encoder alone. X264 is the default and most widely supported. However, if you have a dedicated NVIDIA or AMD graphics card in your system, then you will likely be able to change X264 to either NVENC H264 for NVIDIA or AMD Video Coding Engine H264 for AMD. This will utilize the built-in video encoder on your graphics card to allow you to record a full quality recording without using up system resources. It's really neat. For rate control for recording, I use VBR. However, if you're recording on a low-end computer that is having hiccups with VBR, record CBR with a low bitrate and it should go much better. Again, keyframe intervals should be set to 2. When it comes to recording, the world is yours, depending on your hardware configuration. For my stream VODs, I use the NVIDIA encoder, recorded to a bitrate of about 30,000 kilobits per second, or 30 megabits per second. This is about the quality of the original Elgato Game Capture HD's transfer rate and provides a balance of high quality and lower file size for me. For my normal recording sessions, I use a bitrate of 250 megabits per second or higher. However, I have a dedicated SSD specifically for just recording. If you're just recording to your C drive, you will have limitations depending on how high of a bitrate you can record to, especially on a laptop. Absolutely, make sure you do recording tests and figure out what works for you before jumping in a full Let's Play session and realizing the whole recording is trash. That never feels good. And that's the gist of it. Recording and streaming settings hopefully made a little bit easier. Again, if you're confused about anything, check my full OBS Studio education course linked in the video description for more in-depth videos. I hope this episode of my OBS tutorial course has been helpful for you. If it has, hit the like button, subscribe to my channel for more awesome tech content, come follow me on Twitch if you like game streaming, drop me a hello in chat, and happy streaming!
Thanks for watching this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course. More videos like this and a full master class are linked in the playlist in the video description. Click to learn more. Also, consider joining us on Patreon to help keep tech education free. Go to patreon.com/eposvox to sign up.